Hi, Caleb with Brownells here, and in today's quick tip, we're going to be talking about torque wrenches and how to use them properly, and really, if it really matters that much or not. So if you've ever watched a video online anywhere of someone installing an AR-15 barrel nut, you probably saw a bunch of stuff in the comments that was like, you know, at least 10 people saying you have your torque wrench oriented wrong if you don't have it set up 90 degrees. And before I get too into the weeds here, for those of you who aren't aware, this is a AR-15 upper receiver, okay? And the barrel nut is the part. I'll put the barrel in just like so. The barrel nut is what holds the barrel onto the actual upper receiver. It's just a nut that threads on and keeps it in place. So that this is what we're talking about mainly in this video, whenever I reference barrel nuts. But this applies for pretty much any torque wrench on anything you're doing, working on your car, guns like this, or whatever else you're using torque wrenches on. I don't know, like fixing your wife's KitchenAid mixer. I don't know what people are using torque wrenches for. All right, so first of all, back to what I was saying before. So this one is set up 90 degrees, right? So the actual tool itself, or where the center of the nut, in this case the barrel nut would be, is 90 degrees from the actual driver on the torque wrench. Okay, now if you've seen anyone doing it online and they have it set up like that, or a lot of people's like their main instinct is to just go straight in, then like people lose their mind. It's like the auto mechanics and stuff come on, and let me get something straight here. I'm not hating on the auto mechanics, and they are correct. Whenever they're commenting this, whoever's commenting it is correct. So here's why it matters, if it matters in your case. So whenever you go at 90 degrees, like I'm just gonna do this one here. All right, I'm at 90 degrees. So whatever the reading is on my torque wrench, assuming it's properly calibrated, like let's say I'm at, let's go to 50 foot-pounds. That's a good like in between. All right, so I'm at 50 foot-pounds. So now, because I'm at 90 degrees, the actual torque, that's the actual term, being applied is 50 foot-pounds. So where this gets a little weird, if I am at a less angle, there we go. So if I decrease that angle, the actual torque applied is gonna be greater. And if I increase that angle, the actual torque applied is gonna be less. Now this is the part that is kind of controversial because of how much it may or may not matter. Whenever people are thinking about this, they're like, oh man, because I'm not doing it right, that torque's probably much greater. It's probably, am I doing like 20 foot-pound difference? And the answer to that is no, you're actually probably doing about 4 to 5 foot-pound difference. So for AR-15 barrel nuts, if you're torquing to 50 foot-pounds, honestly, it doesn't matter. Now, yes, I get that it's like bad practice to do it that way and whatnot, but it's not going to make any difference on your AR-15 build. For example, this is a Knights Armament barrel nut wrench, and the specs for that is plus or minus, 50 foot-pounds, and that plus or minus is 5 foot-pounds. So it doesn't matter what angle I have this on this torque wrench, it's going to be within the spec they want it to be. But again, it is bad practice not to do it that way, of course, but for AR-15 barrel nuts, it almost never matters. All right, I feel like I'm getting redundant at this point. So we're just gonna cut it off here. If you're watching this on YouTube and you have anything you'd like to add to this, and I know I didn't hit all the variables or other variables that come into it, like torque wrench length from the driver, not counting those, let us know in the comments down below. We'd like to hear from you. And if you're watching this on the website, and if you just need any help, feel free to give us a call on the tech line. We'll be happy to help you out. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.